Hey, everybody. welcome to episode 4 of Cinema Dare. This is Byron Hussey. I'm joined by Julian Dominguez.
Hey, y'all.
And a very special guest this week, Kerry Brennan.
Hi.
Or Mrs. Byron Hussey.
She doesn't answer to that name.
She does.
I answer to it more often, oddly enough.
So, B-Bars, great news. B-Bars has had a child, not himself.
Whoa, congratulations.
Yeah. He didn't actually clear me to share this, but...
too bad!
It's gone public.
It's public.
Yeah.
He's not available. I know we have a rule here on Cinema Dare where if you miss an episode, you lose a point. But we're gonna waive that for, I guess, children.
Hold on, you didn't tell me about a point system.
Yeah, there's points. I mean,
I didn't know this was the game.
Wait. I wouldn't have. I mean, like, if you had listened to even one episode prior to this point, you would already know about the point system.
Well, just tell me about it, because you know what? Nobody else has listened to it either. So this whole listening public wants to know about the points.
So the premise of this program is that we are we watch movies and we talk over the movie.
Mm-hmm.
And every week or every other week, we take turns daring each other to watch various movies. And the rule is that if one of us has seen the movie, we can't watch it. We have to watch something else.
Okay.
But if nobody's seen the movie, the person that does the dare gets a point.
Okay.
But
it's riveting podcasting.
Yeah. Wait, sorry, I'm doing like a volume check thing that might make a sound. Yeah, okay, there.
It makes it sound pleasant and like
made a sound.
Like,
yeah.
Yeah. Like, so, you can trust listening to this podcast.
Yeah, I'll just keep it up. So wait, did I say also that if you have seen the movie, you get the point, and then we have to go to the Cinema Dare, Double Dare, Dog Dare, Russian Roulette.
Okay, is this totally on the honor system?
Yeah, but yeah. I mean, come on, like, what kind of sociopath would lie on a podcast, you know?
I don't know. I kind of felt you as the all-powerful dictator, and I only tell the truth because of fear of what you might do.
Yeah. I'd sniff it out, too.
Like, yeah. And then what you would do after, that's what terrifies me.
I would do, like, the Larry David... Sorry, I'm doing a couple more volume check. Hit things.
Oh, yes. One more. I didn't hear you say what it was.
Okay. Right. Okay. Sorry. Just the people at home will appreciate this. So yeah, I'm gonna do like the Larry David lie detector on you. You know what that is?
No, I have no idea.
It's like when Larry David thinks you might be lying, and he just kind of stares at you. And some music starts playing. And so on. And he seems to come to some conclusion at the end of this. But
yeah, he'll give a little okay, and I'll back away.
Yeah.
You don't really know if the okay means like okay, I believe you, or okay, I know you're lying.
Yeah,
yeah,
yeah. Wait, you're gonna hear one more little twinkle sound.
Oh,
okay, close that now.
So like logging into my AOL email.
You know that? Remember the welcome, like welcome, you got mail.
That's it.
Yeah, that was actually the guy. It was Steve Case did the recording for that, like the CEO of AOL.
Really?
Yeah, it was like the boss of the whole company saying like "Welcome" every time. And now, presumably, he's like dead or something. I don't know.
Presumably. Like it's just breaking right now, and nobody knows anything yet.
I mean, it must be because AOL was from like the 50s or 60s,
yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
Yeah, exactly. Like that's how generals in the Korean War would communicate with each other.
Exactly. Yeah.
Let's attack here.
Yeah. North Korea is the only country that still uses AOL, I think. Kerry, are you clear on the rules of Cinema Dare?
I know that there are points.
So you get a point.
How many points am I trying to get?
You're not going to get any points.
I'm not going to get any tonight, right?
No.
Unless I say I watched this movie already?
Yeah, but I already know you haven't.
Okay. So if I say I watched this movie, that will veto this movie and we'll get a new one?
No, because I know you haven't seen it and I would know you would be lying.
Okay.
Because you would do the Larry David thing, or is this...
Yeah. I just know. I just know. So this...
That's why I'm afraid of you.
So we take turns, but I also do a sort of a recapping epilogue podcast after every episode with Jan Vandenhemmel, which I've got. I just posted one tonight for. I shouldn't say that because people don't know when we're recording this, but I just posted one a while back. for
like 4 or 5 days ago.
Yeah. What was it? The hard ticket to Hawaii.
I would like to watch that one.
That was a good one.
You can.
Too late.
You know what? Well, you could go to cinemadare.com or biropod.com, and you could check it out. Uh-huh. It's like there to watch.
Yeah. You don't have to go anywhere else. He's done all the work for you.
You don't have to be on the show.
0% chance of that happening.
So Jan, I've been doing this. So Jan is sort of like a fourth Beatle.
I'm sure he loves to be called that.
He's like the D'Artagnan to me, Bivars, and Julian's Three Musketeers. So as such, he is also allowed a dare. Although I'm not sure if it's going to be permanent. Anyway, I'll get on with it. Jan's dare tonight. Long story short, and I will be delivering the dare for him. And the dare is Captain America.
I have seen Captain America.
Ah, well, I don't think you've seen this Captain America. Because this
is this like a really old Captain America we're going to be?
Yeah, this is the 1990 Captain America.
Oh,
I wasn't even born yet.
Yeah. I know.
Have I seen it?
Have you?
If you have. I don't think I have.
Well, let's just take a look here. Let me.
It came out in 1990.
I don't know if it ever made it to theaters. I think it might have.
No. Oh, well, the poster says coming spring 1990 to theaters everywhere.
Yeah, I actually remember seeing the poster when I was a kid. And then
to
the movie,
all theaters.
The movie never came out. It never happened. I was excited.
Just for your theater.
No, just like, come on. Do you remember like a big Captain America movie coming out? Like, you would remember that, right? Like, you remember Batman.
I guess so. But, like, being into Captain America back then was nerdy.
It's true.
I mean, I was into it, but then again, I'm nerdy.
Let me send you. So, it's possible that you have seen this.
Yeah.
Which would mean...
I'm looking at it now, and I think if I've seen any of it, it was like... parody clips on YouTube or whatever. I don't think I've seen it.
So you think that you probably have not seen the entire movie. Okay, are you sure? You don't have to lie, because I've got a whole bunch of,
No. I'm.
Oh,
is
Ned Beatty in this?
I don't know.
Sorry, I'm just looking on the Google.
Well, I mean...
You were hoping for a Ned Beatty movie.
I think he's in it.
If you're
he is.
Looking, then yes! You're the authority, because I have no idea.
Oh, and it's got Michael Norrie, that guy. I remember he was in Fright Night. Remember Fright Night?
Yeah.
Yes.
This is an all-star cast.
Did he play the monster boy?
Yeah. What?
Okay. So, do you need a...
I'm pretty definitive. I haven't seen this one.
Okay. I'm going to send you a link. I think I already sent it to Kerry. Kerry, do you have it?
You did. No.
What a bit
this
cheating.
Is not happening.
Anyway. Okay, I found it. Copy link address, go to Skype, paste. I hope this is the right link.
This is a nice Skype tutorial.
Okay. Bring. And I'm going to have to try to watch it on my phone because really? It's complicated.
Hold on, I don't know what just happened here.
Oh, you have to find the chat window.
Okay.
It's hard on Skype. Skype is not
very
intuitive.
Wait. Okay, so is this just going to... Whoa! It already started. Can you hear that?
Yeah, don't click it yet, Kerry.
But I think it's just going to be noise.
No,
is it going to play?
No, I mean, we won't hear it because you have headphones on.
Okay. But I mean... I'm just going to hit play again because I think it might just be audio that I'm getting. That's what I meant by just noise.
Well, yes.
I don't know if I'm getting a picture.
Huh.
No, I'm not getting a picture. No. Oh, hold on. Maybe if I make it big somehow.
This is
stuff. Okay. I got to go full screen. All right. Never mind.
Good
false alarm. I'll back it up to the beginning.
Okay.
All right. I'm ready to go.
I'm ready to rock.
Ready to go.
Bring it up on my mobile.
Should device. I have like a bottle of wine?
Oh, yeah, that'll make it better.
Yeah, no, nobody's going to try to stop you.
Can't make it worse, right?
Well, I mean, if we were going to try to stop her, how would we do that?
I could, because I'm in the same domicile. Be like a domestic incident, though.
Up to you, Byron. You could be the Captain America of that.
I don't want to end up on cops. Two-thirds. I lost my headphones.
They're on the bed here.
Shit.
They're in my hand. Is this what you want? There you go.
Just take it.
He's got him.
You better have him.
He's heading back into his recording studio now.
Is he running like all awkwardly, like turning?
No,
corner?
he was really taking his time. Like he wasn't taking this seriously at all. He was just like moving along, no sense of urgency.
That's such a disrespect to the viewers.
It was.
I mean, the listeners.
Okay.
And the talent.
Oh, yeah. That's right.
Yeah.
This is the first time I felt any sort of self-respect in the show. So.
Oh.
Okay. I'm set up. I think.
All right. Cool.
All right. So here's how this works, Kerry. Are you at the beginning of the video?
Yeah, it's on 0.00.
Okay, good. And Julian, you're ready to play, right?
Yep.
Okay, so, Kerry, how this works is I do like a countdown of beeps and boops. And on beep. I forget if it's boop or beep.
So, it was
on
it
the
was
third
beep.
Sound
so
I make at the end of the sound.
Boop, boop,
push play. Yeah, boop, boop, beep. So at the end of the beep, push play, okay? You got that?
Yep.
Okay, ready?
At the end, he'll beep, and then when it stops, we press it.
Okay. At the
sound.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right.
Okay, ready? Boop. Boop. Beep.
All right.
Is it playing?
Oh, yeah.
Do you guys see like a 21st century thing? Okay, good. Technology.
All right. Now, I can't hear you guys now. I can only hear this.
You have to solve that problem yourself.
A little bit. Porto Venere, Italy.
Porto Venere.
We're in Italian. We were just kidding with our American accents.
I thought this was Captain America, not Captain Italy.
Italy?
Captain Italy? What would Captain Italy do?
He'd have a big pizza pie instead of a shield.
Ooh, I like that.
Yeah.
Captain
a good
Italy,
font.
He doesn't care about the children.
It's J.D. Salinger's brother. Oh, Ronnie Cox, he's big.
I don't know who Ronnie Cox is.
Ned Beatty.
That's Courtney Cox's dad.
Yeah.
Really?
Yeah, he was in Total Recall.
I just think about her having a dad and then him shaking his head disapprovingly when he saw her in that Bruce Springsteen video.
Oh, no, that was proudest moment. I thought you were going to say when he saw her on her wedding day marrying that strange Arquette boy.
I just saw...
Cat boy?
Did you say... Arquette boy. Remember she married
David
Arquette? David Arquette.
He did? She did?
And then he, I think he got arrested.
Am I making that up?
No.
No, you may be right. I don't know.
I'm totally right.
Fork over the pizza pies. Sorry.
It's like they're attacking Tiny Tim's house, or Timmy O'Toole, or whatever his name is.
Timmy O'Toole.
From Christmas Carol.
Yeah, Timmy O'Toole.
Timmy O'Toole.
Should there be subtitles here?
No, that was pretty clear. We all speak Italian.
Okay, we got the subtitle a little bit later, and that's fine. So is you think a movie called Captain America would start in America? Like, speak English, you know? This is America.
Just outsourcing all our jobs.
Build the wall, take the oil.
Uh-huh. Take the oil, take our movies.
We're going to make them pay for the wall.
Make the Italians pay for the wall. So this is literally World War II. This is his origin story.
I guess so.
In
Lorenzo.
I'm a mouse. Where's my cheese?
It's racist.
Yeah.
Calamari.
Is he the inspiration for that Ratatouille movie?
Yeah.
they're all bored.
I think that was in France, though.
So. Oh.
Yeah. Is that Wallace Shawn? Remember, he drank all the poison on The Princess Bride?
Oh!
It's not him, but...
The Sicilian.
Yeah.
Oh, my God.
He's Hellboy? He's shivering. Poor little guy.
I think that's the super soldier serum that is given to...
Oh, the rat.
Oh, cool. My God.
Really good special effects.
Jim Henson wouldn't think so.
Mussolini's really proud of his rat monster. It is Mussolini.
It'll die in 12 minutes, but we love it.
Oh, it's her. What's her name from the Austin Powers?
Frau
Farbissinen.
Yeah. Yeah, the one that loved his son.
Yeah. Seth Green.
God!
Is that really her?
She looks too tall.
Yeah, Farbissinen.
I don't know.
Short.
I want to say it's her.
It's her. No way to ever know or contradict this statement.
As I close up IMDb.
Is this the origin of the Red Skull, maybe?
Oh, probably. That looked like a Red Skull
but
rat.
The Red Skull isn't Italian.
What do you know?
I know that he's not Italian.
Maybe he just like,
called him
an Red Italian...
Skull.
Yeah, he went to a British or American school.
No, she was talking about the Count of Monte Cristo, I think.
Oh my God.
Stop it! That's annoying!
They're going to make him watch, like, porn and nuclear explosions, like in Clockwork Orange. He's going to just hate Italian food.
And he'll just come out normal. Like, he won't want to kill or rob or do anything.
Yeah.
I'll just be like, it was dumb.
7 years later in the 90s. All right, the Holocaust is in full swing. Oh, so you
in United the White States. House.
Who do you think is going to play the president? Ned Beatty?
I hope so. Either Ned Beatty...
Steve Rogers. So this is where Captain America's from, not Brooklyn. Redondo Beach, California.
Hold on, guys. Got to let the dog out. So
that's cool, man. I would like the dog to join in the discussion.
It's a good-looking cake.
Yeah, pretty quality. This really brings me back.
To what?
My youth in the 40s.
Oh, good old days.
Yeah. I remember wearing. Is that a members only jacket?
That's my joke.
What is he, the last member?
Who's the last member?
That's like the 40s guy outfit.
Yeah, he's got like the deep pleats in the
Yeah.
pants. I don't make him like that anymore.
Yeah, he's dressed like Don Draper, but like not going to work, like just the hanging around the house Don Draper.
He wishes he looked that cool.
Like the Don Draper that like goes on a picnic and like
Don
litters.
Draper on a picnic still wore like a nice sports coat.
He wore stuff like this.
Sorry about that, guys.
It's all right.
Taking care of my sister's dog, and you know what I didn't do before I started this? I took him for a walk.
Oh, is that Baron?
Yeah, got Baron here,
He's a
Baron
good guy.
underbite.
He's a good dude. Can you give him a like a pat on the head for
I'll
me?
give him a boop on the face.
Yeah.
There you go.
Next
Oh.
time you see him. Is that
So
what's his name
did I
from
miss any serious action?
No, Kerry was talking over the whole movie. I couldn't hear anything.
We were just discussing his outfit. I was commenting on the deep pleats in his pants. They don't make them like that anymore. It's a real shame.
It's funny because in real life, I bet Captain America would have smoked like a lot. He was constantly
Probably.
smoking
Well,
cigarettes because it was like the thing to do at the time.
yeah, and
Everybody smoked.
there was a version of Captain America in the comics that they came out with where he would hit kids because that's just what they did. Yeah.
That's what
Yeah,
you did back
it was
then.
like when.
So this is Steve Rogers right here that I'm looking at.
Yeah.
I
Is this
guess.
before he became Captain
Yeah, look
America,
at what a
or did
weenie he
they
is.
just fix his limp?
He's a weenie. They're gonna
Yeah.
unweenify him.
He's
Look.
not Mr. Atlas yet.
Actually, this is pretty good. I mean, it seems like it had pretty high production values to me.
I mean, just that shot there looked pretty good. Oh.
Is that Agent Carter?
Yes. Who is Agent Carter?
Oh, come on.
Nope.
Didn't you even see the recent Captain America
Nope.
reboot? You didn't see Captain America,
Negative.
the. What's it called? The First Avenger?
Winter Soldier.
First Avenger.
Is that his first one? Or no, this is his first one.
Yeah, this is the first one. That's the sequel to this, canonically.
Yeah,
oh, there she
Winter
is.
Soldier is part of the trilogy.
Right, so they brought her. I thought she got shot in midair.
No. She
Because
was
she.
climbing over the rocks.
Yeah,
Remember,
and she
nobody's even
was.
chasing her. They shot a few bullets at her, and then they just ignored her.
She
And
went
then she
into
had
the ocean,
7 years
which
to get
means.
away.
Yeah. She swam the whole way. That
Yeah.
was supposed to denote her defecting.
They're like, what? She can't do anything. She's just a woman. This is the 40s.
Is that the
And
mom from E.T.?
I thought it was Sally Field.
It's definitely not Sally Field.
Yeah, there you go,
Oh, he does
smoker.
smoke. See, yeah.
It was also okay in the 90s too.
It's true. It
So,
really wasn't that
who
long ago
knows?
that we decided it was just universally
Yeah.
bad. It's like, yeah, you could still smoke in like the mall at this point.
Yeah, and in restaurants, have your steak in a cig.
Yeah.
Ugh.
Well, it's like, the weird thing is like restaurants is like a horrible place to smoke, but that was like one of the last holdouts. But like even like in this like 7-Eleven, you could just light up like after you bought. You could like open the pack right at the counter and just like light up, like give a match, and like guy would light it
I never
for
saw that once in my life.
you.
These 7-Elevens. What
I did that just last week,
you
guys.
I feel
talking
like my dad did that once.
about?
I do remember
I
him
have this
smoking the
orange juice ready
Wawa.
for you.
Ooh, a pot roast.
Is that Bucky?
I'll cook it with a gun.
I think flirting. That cash register looks like a friendly robot.
So just your friendly neighborhood government robot. Yeah. Get down there already. Let's make out.
They're going to make the Hulk. It's going to happen.
Joke's on you, viewers.
Bait and switch. Classic bait and switch. It's called Captain America, but it's all Hulk.
America Hulk.
Captain Hulk. America.
Hulk Erica.
What's his name? The guy from the
first,
you know. John Hurt.
Him, I know. So, wait a minute. Wasn't it like a super serum that they gave him?
Yeah.
Like, what's with all the, like, machinery and high tech?
That's where they keep the serum.
Just like in that supercomputer?
Yeah. They're about to explain it.
Yeah, like, what are you, simple?
Laser beam involved.
It looks a little bit like a Joaquin Phoenix.
Who does?
Captain America.
Okay. Hold on, let me cut your lip and see if you still look like him.
That's what I was. He looks like he had a repaired cleft palate.
A surgically repaired face.
Yeah.
Joaquin Phoenix just isn't charming anymore.
He may not be right super. There.
He may suck, but he'll be okay.
Very meta.
Yeah.
This is a Pantera video. Kerry, are you still watching the movie?
Yeah, I'm riveted.
You're not watching like yoga videos, are you?
No.
Is that a guy peeping?
Yeah. It's like he wasn't invited to the room, but gosh darn it, he's going to see this guy get buff anyway.
I don't want to miss the man show. Starring Jimmy Kimmel. I just remembered that the man show was a real thing after I said it out loud.
What? Oh.
It was like, yeah, with you know, the man Jimmy show, Kimmel, like, I just thought it was like a show with men in it, but then it was like, oh yeah, Adam Carolla and Jimmy Kimmel did a show that was called that.
Yeah.
It's really stupid.
So your sexy show of men wasn't what you got. Sorry, Byron.
It's all right. He looks no different.
But I bet he doesn't limp anymore.
That's true.
Get me off this restraints. I gotta show you my new non-limping powers.
Mm-hmm.
Did they say Roosevelt in the olden days?
Jesus.
Oh, man!
It was a Bravura
performance.
Act two?
Already? Has act one started yet?
It's very, very fast moving with plot development.
Yeah, it's Frank Grimes from, remember Grimey from The Simpsons?
Oh, yeah. That's how he died, didn't
he? Yeah,
didn't
he was like, look at me, I'm Homer Simpson. I can grab these live wires and nothing will happen. And then he died.
I'm going to ignore safety and be just like Homer Simpson.
Yeah.
And then he kicks the bucket.
Yeah, The Simpsons like fans really hated that episode when it came out. And probably still do. They kind of hated every episode, I think.
I don't know. I kind of liked it.
I thought it was pretty good.
It just depends. There was a time where there was a serious drop off.
Oh yeah, it's definitely. That was after the drop off also, but it was still
okay.
Somewhere in the middle of the decline, you know, not at the rock bottom.
No. I hear a debonair man out there. Dashing even.
Anybody call for a super soldier hunk? Well, this is awkward. Pretty.
I'm Captain America. I don't need no planes.
All right. They got him in the Captain America spandex already.
Why is he wearing that?
Kerry, did you? This movie's called Captain America, not Captain Doesn't Wear a Mask. I hear a dog.
Yep. So now I gotta pet him and give him love while I watch a movie. Right, Baron? Right, Baron, are you Captain America in Dog World? Yeah.
Can you get Baron to bark?
Hmm?
Can you get him to bark?
Baron? Baron? No, he's just staring at me with his massive underbite.
So there's a little bit of exposition here. Apparently his uniform is fireproof. That's probably really? Going to come back at some point when they light him on fire.
It's a Chekhov's gun that they're doing.
It's going to be like a bunch of hippies, like, we're going to burn the flag, man. And he's going to be like, burn this flag, boys. And he's going to kill them all.
He's going to decapitate them with the shield.
That's very un-American. It'll be a lethal injection all the way.
Oh. With a huge machine like the one that delivered the super serum?
Is this really the best way to introduce his costume, like underneath another costume?
It's kind of like a shitty Superman.
He looks like the Tick. Hey, you know the Tick? They're bringing the Tick back on Netflix.
Yeah, they are. Yeah.
Did he say, I love you, Bernie?
Bernie! Feel the burn!
Oh my god, he's a Bernie bro.
He's a Bernie bro.
He's a burn bot.
Bernie bot?
Bernie bot.
Is that... Can you do that? Like, I thought you... copyrighted that variation.
Yeah, you're right. I should sue Bernie Sanders.
Yep, you should. You should. Where did he have the wings on the helmet?
They didn't. They
just flapped down?
Flapped down, yeah.
Or does he have to, like, clip them on when he takes off the helmet?
He's got, like, a button, and, like, they're collapsible. Like,
his whole backpack is a huge mechanical apparatus to flap up the wings.
Whoa! That was awesome.
Kids across America lost their shit.
Because it looked like Lincoln Logs, too. Like, you could have done that effect with your toys.
Yeah. And even worse, it's like they took their Lincoln Logs and used bubble gum to stick them together.
It was weird. It's like I remember like what Lincoln Logs taste like. It's like I was young enough when I had them that I was like teething on them or something, and I remember the flavor.
What did they taste like? Popsicle sticks?
Wood. It wasn't quite the same as a popsicle stick. It was like a softer,
just like regular wood.
Yeah,
you could just be thinking about popsicle sticks, but putting it on Lincoln Logs, and that's so disingenuous.
Yeah.
Yes.
Did they taste better or worse than crayons?
Just different.
Crayons were delicious.
Just different. The latter.
I hated Play-Doh.
Play-Doh is a salty snack.
Mom, we're running out of grated Parmesan cheese.
Hey, looks pretty good actually, except for it doesn't really look like a skull.
But it's like the rat just got bigger.
But I think Julian, he's not the rat. It's a different guy. This is the kid, I think. He plays Ultimate.
I think you mean Froth.
No, it's different. Ultimate's like soccer with frisbees. Froth is golf with frisbees.
It's just called Ultimate now?
If you're in the know.
Are you in the know? You're in
obviously.
The know, aren't you?
Obviously. A lot of good Foley work in this movie.
Yeah.
Kerry, do you know what Foley work is?
I don't.
It's like sound effects.
Yeah.
You know how, like, in a movie when something's, like, squishy?
I know what a sound effect is.
Well, it's like they'll record it separately, though. And that's a Foley artist will do that. Am I mansplaining this?
Mm-hmm.
Look, toots.
This might be a little bit above your understanding because you're a lady.
Oh no,
that would be terrible.
Is that Mussolini again? Was it? Is it supposed to be Mussolini? Oh, so the movie's over. You already failed.
It was it just me or did that feel like an end fight? Like
it did.
Okay, we're finally facing off.
This movie is progressing really quickly.
Yeah, it's got some pacing. Like,
I don't even understand how we got from the hospital bed to here. So quickly. Did he have any training?
He's super strong, super soldier.
He's super trained. It's like Act 6 already.
Yeah.
I do. I wonder why they decided to make him Italian. It's like such an obvious German like character. Like Germans, you know. Just so nefarious, you know, Germans, all Germans by default.
Yeah.
Like every German person, you know. This is really gonna work?
Oh, I get it. Okay.
Is this a dream?
No. This is like the story that they crafted later on to explain why Captain America was in our time.
Oh, yeah, that's right. I forgot he still had to get to the 90s.
Launch a nuke. He gets frozen underwater.
Yeah.
Gets unfrozen decade later.
That's right. Okay. I kind of forgot, like, that it had to come into modern times.
Yeah, I forgot, too. Yeah, and that's why in the comics he's, like, beating on kids who are, like, ruffians on the street. Because, you know.
Yeah.
1943, Captain America did it. And
yeah.
It's cool.
If their parents don't do it, somebody has to.
Yeah. Better watch out, kid. Captain America's out there.
It's the 4th of July. Captain America's going to fly down the chimney with hot
Captain
dogs.
Captain America's going to get you.
Every single one of our holidays should have like a Santa Claus character associated with it that like gives you something.
Or takes.
Yeah. Every holiday should have a protagonist and an antagonist.
Mm-hmm.
There's a constant battle for your
affection. Yes.
Well, do they both? Does every holiday have both, or do they alternate? Like Christmas, you get a gift, but New Year's, baby, New Year slides down the chimney and takes your spoons.
You have 7 days to enjoy your gift before you have to defend it.
Exactly. Oh, I love it.
All right. Who's in charge of these things? We can lobby to make this.
Someone in Greenwich, right?
Like Greenwich Mean Time?
Yeah.
Yeah.
If time starts there, holidays start there, right?
Yeah, maybe it's like something to do with the Tropic of Capricorn.
I'm a Capricorn. I'll do it.
It's quite a leap.
I'll take care of it.
Is that a nuke sailing right towards that boy?
Yeah.
It's a 4th of July miracle.
Jimmy, here are your hot dogs.
I almost died.
Wow.
What year is that kid in?
1943.
I think Baron has, I think he has cabin fever. He's walking around and staring at me,
Does he like Captain America?
Hey, Baron, what do you think about Captain America?
He's like, I don't like it at all.
I'm German.
We're rocks.
Like, constantly paranoid he's going to pee on something.
Is he a peer? Is that a little Christmas tree there?
He's very housebroken.
Is that a Netflix DVD there?
Yep.
Looked like one of those Netflix ones.
Yep. It was the first Emmanuel. The kids are gonna really explore the female anatomy.
Is that Ralphie?
Yeah, it's Ralphie from the Christmas Tale.
It is.
Tale.
Holy.
From A Christmas Tale.
Yeah. Was he also in Lean on Me?
No.
Damn. There was a boy who looked like him, right?
That was Oh, what's that guy's name?
Cueball, Sean Mallory.
No.
He was in it, though, right?
No.
Or Morgan Freeman was in it, right?
No. Will.
What are you talking about? Wait, what? What
Stand
are
By
about?
Me.
Stand by me.
Lean on Me.
Oh, I said Lean by Me. No, they're two meme movies, so.
Stand by Me had Will Wheaton.
Will Wheaton.
River Phoenix.
Corey Feldman.
Corey Feldman.
And Cueball, whose name I can't remember.
Cueball Quinn Mallory, yeah, from Sliders.
Mallory. It didn't have Sean Astin?
No.
You're thinking of the Goonies.
Mm. Yeah, he was in that.
You're thinking of Lord of the Rings, Julian.
Yeah.
Who's Cueball? What's that guy's name?
Yeah.
Married Rebecca Romijn.
Really?
Yeah. What's his name?
I just can't think of it.
All right, listeners. This is the time in the podcast where
Jerry O'Connell.
Jerry O'Connell. Yeah.
Oh, okay, listeners. You don't have to email us the answer anymore.
I got it.
Forever in the future.
All this retro stuff is happening. I'm nostalgic.
I love a good montage.
A newspaper montage?
Mm-hmm. Current events montage.
It's like what Austin Powers did.
Yeah.
Watching TV and listening to the record, but doing it horribly. By God.
Soviet nuclear accident.
So Captain America is just sleeping right through all of this?
Yeah.
No.
That's him. That's Cox.
It's all his fault.
He's going to be a villain because he always plays a villain.
Wait, that's Courtney Cox's father?
Yeah.
Son of a bitch. I don't trust him already. Give me a Baron. I know you had the pee-pee, but it's not going to happen. Oh.
It's Cohagen. That's what his...
He probably oh, that is Cohagen.
Man. This makes Jimmy Carter's malaise speech look like, Ronald Reagan's... what was the one where Ronald Reagan was like something about Star Wars? May the Force be with
you. Also from A Christmas Story.
Oh, it's Ralphie's dad, right?
Still fired up about those Bumpus hounds.
Bumpus hounds. Did he always seem a little bit old to be a father of such a young boy?
Kinda.
Well, I don't know if you know this, but men can make babies. Like
yeah, but the motility of the sperm really does reduce significantly with age. I mean, it becomes more difficult. Just picture his sperm, okay?
No.
Let's zoom all the way in to his the sort of the gonadal region. So the sperm would have very slow tails.
He can hear that barking.
Yeah. It was kind of he was commenting on this from discussion too.
Before we were so rudely interrupted by a dog in the future.
And this is present day here in evil villain castle. Is that statue at the table too? It looks like they moved that statue like to a seat on the table.
It's Robert Duvall. This is going to be an Oscar caliber. Robert
Duvall. What the?
He's fine. He's wearing all makeup.
He's okay. Just give him a couple of baby aspirin.
Just rub a little dirt on it, Red Skull. You'll be fine.
Anyway.
Looks like Berlusconi.
It's like when Jack Nicholson was a Joker and putting on the regular face paint.
That was even scarier.
Yeah.
Berlusconi, what's his name? Silvio Berlusconi, former Prime Minister of Italy. Kerry.
He looks just like him.
Yeah, he had orgies.
Oh, him.
Yeah. Bunga Bunga parties is what he called them.
Bunga Bunga parties?
Mm-hmm. Huge, big, good friend of Vladimir Putin. Did I say big
Vladimir
friend?
Putin?
I think these guys
What's
should
going
know
on here?
This guy is evil. Like, why would you voluntarily work with him?
Why is anybody meeting with him right now? Who is he? Who's he supposed to be?
The Red Skull.
That's Donald Trump, right?
No, it's Robert Duvall.
So it's Robert Duvall, Julian. Fuck.
Come on.
Just look it up on IMDb,
this is,
please.
Nepal, right?
Yeah.
Is that Jesse Pinkman? Oh no, it's Casey Affleck.
Yeah, it does look a little Affleck-y.
This guy is frozen. It's science, bitch.
Magnets. You should try to get him out of the ice with a magnet.
Yeah, it's an adamantium shield, so you just use a magnet. Boop. Captain America is out of the ice, and
initially they thought this was some delicious strawberries trapped in the ice.
Is that why he was trying to get in?
Yeah.
There's only one way Captain America's getting out of this pickle. It's almost comedic, his hand sticking out like that.
Yeah, it's like a tragic comedy.
Yeah.
Surprise, motherfuckers!
It just starts knocking everyone the fuck out.
He blames them for his plight.
You're all Germans!
Is this like a fetish latex outfit?
He's getting turned on. He's unzipping.
Oh, God, the smell!
When was the last time you showered? 1943. He's going to die in the snow again.
I'm going to walk back to Washington, D.C.
He just jumps into the hole they carved the ice out of.
Why did he just left?
This is my home. Been my home for the last 4 to 5 years.
Yeah, they just really yada yada through a lot of...
Through the
there he is.
It's Ned Beatty.
Mm-hmm.
Is he Warren Beatty's brother?
Yes.
Really, he got the raw end of the deal on the looks department.
Warren?
No, Ned. Warren is like a dream.
He turns
dream
us on.
Hunk.
Well.
It's kind of like who's. I'm sorry. Go ahead.
Well, I was just gonna say it looks like Ned Beatty here is a Gryffindor, so some points for him.
He's kind of like the lesser cared about Baldwin brother.
You mean the lesser cared about like three Baldwin brothers?
All of them except for one Baldwin brother.
Yeah, and even that one's wearing a little thin. Although those Alexa commercials are pretty good. With
30 Rock helped them out.
Yeah, no, for sure, for sure.
In Italy, we give you money.
That's how they got into so much trouble financially. Give it too many handouts. Kerry is part Italian.
Oh, yeah?
Yep. Mm-hmm.
It's true.
Sweet.
Also, we had a pizza for dinner.
We had a pizza pie.
I like the way that you said it, but you used the accent just a little bit. Like, it was kind of like under your breath, like, we had a pizza.
We had a pizza party for dinner. Mamma mia, that's spicy meatball.
Oh, we should get the guy who does the voice of Mario here.
Can we?
Charles, what's his name? Charlie Martinet?
I feel like we would have to pay him a lot of money.
I don't know, dude. Have you seen his Instagram?
No.
He just walks around with the Mario dolls and does their voice in weird situations.
I feel like...
Does he also do Luigi?
Yeah, and Wario.
Oh, I have Luigi. I've got a Luigi doll here right next to me.
Can you make it talk, Kerry? Can you make the Luigi talk?
All he says is, hey, Luigi!
Why would he say his own name? Like, he's
That's
talking
all about... he says.
He's like a Smurf, but more so.
Wait a minute. Has he just been wandering? How did they get a picture of him in the paper? Why didn't he just go back with those guys? Is he stupid?
Oh, well, that was the picture that the turned on scientist took.
I know, but why did he run away?
He's walking. He's walking home because
yeah,
he can't.
He's so confused.
His limp is fixed.
He wants to pull a Rambo.
Testing out his new legs.
You guys don't. Where is you he? Guys Somewhere don't. You guys don't know what's going. You're just pretending to know. You don't know why.
I don't know why.
I don't know what you're talking about, Byron. We've been paying attention.
Like, he woke up from a deep freeze and a deep sleep.
And he
was
left.
He confused?
Okay. Well, let's do this. If you woke up from a deep freeze, what would you do?
I would, if there were, it was like a bunch of scientists, and with like airplanes and stuff, you know what I'd do? I'd be like, guys, can you give me a ride back to civilization? And also, can you help me not be frozen anymore?
That's actually a pretty solid plan. I think we misjudged you.
So I'm just asking, like, for the sake of argument, why did he run away? If the answer is that he's confused because he was frozen for 50 years, fine, that's the answer. But is that what we're supposed to think? I don't know.
I think his terrifying look up at whirly birds.
Yeah, they're...
And
helicopters.
People dressed weird.
Weren't invented yet in the 40s.
Yeah, I think they were.
It's like Excite Bike.
Yeah. 10 points.
Yep.
30 points.
Like, he's such a pussy.
Why is he so slow?
He's slow and he's a scaredy cat.
Isn't he supposed to be Captain America?
Come on, Rogers, step up your game.
So slow.
On your left.
You got a super
on
serum
your left.
Or mediocre serum.
On your left. Remember from? Did he have panty left. Line? Thought I saw a panty line.
Take that, American.
Ned Beatty here. Is he the kid from earlier? The Christmas Story kid? Is he Ralphie growing up?
Yeah, probably.
Because he's wearing that pencil in his glasses the same way
him.
The other kid was.
Yeah.
And now he remembers him from his youth.
And he's soft and round like the kid.
Is that Paula Poundstone?
I got a joke to tell you!
Hey, Captain. Hey, Captain America. How's this Paula Poundstone imitation for you? Pretty spot on, huh?
That's... It's magic. It's like she's in the room.
What's the deal with that spray cheese you can buy?
Classic Paula Poundstone.
Oh, that's so Paula. he looks really stoned.
The whole time looking at him like, who the fuck are you?
Got a Hershey bar.
Chocolate.
I bet he didn't like reading that. It says made in Japan on it. What did I do?
Oh,
they're actually making a thing of it.
It's like those sandal wearing I forgot the line.
Oh, I wanted to just punch this guy for having a Japanese recorder.
Oh.
Oh, he solved it.
Is this Hydra?
What are we doing thinking it's Lee Harvey Oswald?
Sandal wearing goldfish tenders. That's what the Japanese are.
Jesus.
Don't you remember from The Simpsons?
No. What episode?
It was the one with Mr. Burns's father, and he caught the kid stealing atoms.
Oh, yeah.
And he's like, we're going to be eaten alive by the Japanese. And he's like, the Japanese, those sandal-wearing goldfish tenders.
I felt like you took the last 20, 30 seconds to, like, formulate that in your head and
well, you had to Google it.
Yeah.
It was worth it. Because it's like it was so funny. It was so funny to explain this joke.
You didn't rip it. You just sampled someone else's joke.
No, I mean, I was directly referencing another joke, yeah. Is he throwing up? He's done nothing heroic yet. And now he's throwing up.
Got his ass beat and shot out on a rocket. Scared by scientists. Hit a woman with his shield. That was gonna punch him. I'm gonna steal your car. What a chode.
Oh.
Captain America's a dick.
You die of exposure.
The one guy who helped him.
Yeah, he's a huge dick.
I guess it's time to steal this guy's car.
It's like, this guy's nuts. Canada.
You mean they're not the 52nd state already?
He doesn't know how car gas works.
He's in the middle of the road just scratching his head. It was going for an hour, and then it's not going.
He's a really irresponsible borrower. Car borrower.
So far in this movie, Captain America has been more of a burden than anything else. Now he's a drifter and a drain on society.
Molson Light.
He's already had like 14. The 90s is hard.
Drunken hobo for the rest of the century, and then. Is Captain America, like, immortal? Like, is he, like, a...
He's not a god like Thor.
Yeah. But no, Thor... and they had to freeze him in ice to make him live so long.
Yeah, but I mean, like, he didn't die from it.
Like, neither did the caveman in Scooby-Doo.
Wasn't that a prank? Like... Isn't it usually like a guy that wants to buy some property for cheap? So he was...
Shit. You're too smart for me.
It's like, that's the only plan they can come up with.
Yeah.
Whoa!
Just knock her out.
Wait, that's the end of that scene? I wanted to see him kick those punks' asses.
Yeah. No, but he's scared of them.
Oh, like he's going back to his hometown in Redondo Beach.
Oh, that's right. So now he's going to see his old lady.
It's going to be like that scene in Back to the Future where Marty goes back to the alternate 1985 where Biff Tannen is the president.
Except it's like not. And yes. Like, no, you're right.
And there's like you can tell it's a bad neighborhood because there's a Michael Jackson poster on the wall.
the future of America.
Yeah. What does he have in that satchel? Hey man, you gonna make some pizzas?
No, it's just a sombrero I'm gonna dance on later.
Oh man, I'm totally into some Mexican dancing, man. I will come over.
No, it's only for one.
Just a solo act.
Now he's having delusions.
Whoa.
Captain America knocked out by beer.
It's great old lady makeup.
Don't smile too hard, it might pop off. Was he about to throw down Captain America?
He was.
He's like, Captain America, oh, fuck that.
It just ravaged your face.
Jeez, honey, you look horrible. So, I regret coming here.
Who's this chump? Stay away from my woman, pal. What have you been doing with her the last 50 years?
Hey, you stallion of a man. Don't touch my wife. They start making out on the lawn.
He has some pacing problems. Like, I don't think we're ready to slow down this much here. Let's do some. I think we need an action scene. Come on, Bernie. Karate chop his neck. Come on. Look at those really convincing liver spots. They're like.
That was there super serum in that milk? They perfected the delivery system super serum.
Bovine growth hormones. It's like
that's what it was.
Super serum. That's pathetic. Loser.
God, loser. Your house sucks.
God.
Jesus.
This is actually pretty similar to some stuff that happened in the new Captain America movies.
Kinda, yeah. Like this, like meeting people you knew. He knew. Yeah, they painted liver spots on her hairline only.
Yeah, I pointed that earlier, man. Where were you?
Truth be told, I muted it and just walked away.
That's fine.
No real reason. I just.
You needed a break. You needed to cool off.
I needed a break. This is pretty intense. You guys are good.
This movie is really long, by the way.
Like, Act 18.
It's an hour and 37 minutes long.
It's a lot of people he used to know that he has to meet. He looks like he's frustrated with how long the movie is.
Yeah.
Fuck. He threw a shield at my face. She should just pick up a shield nearby and throw it at his face.
This guy,
make him feel.
They should just call him Red Face.
That's what his lady friend calls him.
This is not really a skull.
No.
Do you think that's a mask?
Over the skull?
Yeah.
Or like he... painted?
Do you think he got one of those face transplants they do?
Yeah, the ones they do like down the street.
Well, they've done it twice, I think, or three times. It's always a little scary.
Did they ever do any honor before 1990?
No. No. It's very recent. But this is fiction. So.
What was it you called it? The willful...
willful suspension of disbelief.
I feel like that's your catchphrase.
No, I mean, it's like a saying, you know, it's an expression.
It's a real thing, Julian.
It's a real thing. I mean, it's like, if you Google it, you'll see that other people than me have said it in the past.
You know how long a phrase that is for me to type into Google?
Too long, I agree.
Oh, well... You just put willful SU and I get willful suspension of disbelief.
Yeah. Ooh, time for some mimosas, ladies.
First ladies. Coined by Byron Hussey in 2013.
What's going on? Why are we getting rock? Why is rock on a beer playing? Jet?
That was an act transition. You remember those, Byron?
Betamax? Kerry, that cat is probably dead by now. Old age. Julian, what are you laughing at that for? It's really sad.
Oh my god.
Kerry, are you still here?
I'm here.
Are you okay? I mean, but
you just dropped a bomb on her, dude.
I'm just hanging out with my own live living cat.
It's possible that the cat is still alive. This movie was made in 1990. Probably filmed largely in 1989.
26 years ago.
Sorry, what did you
say? It wouldn't be the oldest cat in the world, Julian.
No. This guy's already... Come on.
And that's true. You are right. There are older cats. What? What is that she has?
It's a taser gun. Is that Christian Bale?
It's a lethal taser gun. What is it?
I think it's a Talk Boy from Home Alone 2.
Sweet taser beans. That tases huge holes in your chest.
Do you think they just like weren't allowed to show guns because of the comics code?
What's the comics code?
That's comics. It is a movie. But this is a moving picture.
Yeah, but it's a movie about a comic book.
There's no guns in the comics?
There are, but I just like.
Yeah, Byron.
That's a nice shirt. Not hers. That's fine too.
That's very insensitive. But it's a nice vest.
Yeah. She's getting ready to do a shift down at Tchotchke's. Yeah. She's got 800 pieces of flair. Is that Uncle Ben? Is she going to turn into Spider-Man?
She becomes Spider-Man.
Scott Bakula.
It looks more like Ario Speedwagon.
Like, Scott.
That's his name. Ario Speedwagon. Mr. Speedwagon. What's a Speedwagon? It's like a station wagon that they put like NOS on it or whatever you call that stuff.
It's like a station wagon. You cook, like meth.
A meth wagon?
Mm-hmm. No, I mean, speed is another word for meth, so. We could go back to saying speed wagon, and it still works. I just ate a Reese's cup. I don't know if you could hear me chewing. Probably you guys couldn't, but, like, the listeners at home probably heard it.
I respect our listeners and their ability to listen better than I can.
So now, like, three characters are either dead or convalescing. Mm-hmm. And we're just going to focus on that from here on out.
Oh, that's a sweet turtleneck.
Yeah.
Sweet turd. Yeah, sweet turd.
Sweet turd. Sweet turt. Cap turd.
Turt with a apostrophe at the end.
A turt.
Sweet turt.
It's a turt.
Who is this guy? He's nobody. He's really literally like the husband of somebody that used to know him. Like he's not an important character.
He was
in the early scenes too as a young man.
He wasn't the general, was he?
I don't know. He was a something.
We just know that because he has a mustache.
Oh, his mustache. He was that dashing general outside. Yeah. No, it's all coming together. now with Captain America out of the way, I can play with her lady parts.
Gross. That's a sweet TV. Do you think this is an ISIS-related incident?
Yes. Sounds like it.
I think this is an ISIS attack.
Yep.
Same shit, different asshole. That's Captain America's most famous expression.
Same shit, different asshole. That should be the hashtag.
All right. Done.
Called it. I want to take a photo of Captain America.
I don't think I've ever actually seen anybody use one of the hashtags from any of my podcasts.
We just got to find a better way to deliver them.
I think people need to actually listen to the...
Yeah.
The shows. That's,
that is a better way to deliver.
Because, like, you think about it, it's like probably only, like... Was he signaling to Carol Burnett's mother?
Mm-hmm.
Grandmother?
He did that before in that hospital scene.
Man. So he's a Hydra.
I'm telling you. This movie is so well constructed.
I'm cooking pies.
At Hydra headquarters.
Is this Route 1?
Yep.
Quick, Route 1. I mean, it's in California, so probably not, but looks like it.
Welcome to Roz's Cafe.
Doesn't he know? This isn't the 40s anymore where they had unisex bathrooms.
And no genders.
It was a more liberal time.
It was a simpler time. You didn't have to conjugate.
Oh, here we go. This is where I'm going to spy on ladies peeing from.
Why was it
on.
So hard for him to break through that drywall?
Because he's a pussy.
Yeah. He's Captain America.
Come on, there's some equipment back here. I've been recording women peeing for like 40 years. I've got to look at all these tapes.
Probably long gone.
This is just like that scene in the new Captain America movie where they...
Where he's looking for his Peeping Tom tapes?
No, they're like in a basement. There's a missile.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, yeah.
And the computer comes to life?
Yep. Baron Zemo? Did he just caress that?
Yep.
Wait, how is this suddenly proof of stuff being true?
Because it wasn't explained very well, and like every other things in this movie, things weren't explained well.
But how does these surroundings explain anything to her?
Because he's moved by it emotionally.
We've got a really good hiding spot.
He was
everything
probably
okay.
Looking at that woman's skirt. Another pervy moment from Captain America.
So many vests in this movie.
Very high fashion. What a way is that to hold a gun? Like, you fire it, it'll like blow out your hand.
Oh, you Mr. like firearm safety suddenly, Julian?
Come on.
Have you ever fired a gun?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I have two.
What?
I have.
I have two.
Sweet. Now we're gun brothers.
Yep. Did you like one of the cool big guns?
The bigger the better.
I shot a little one and a big one.
Oh, yeah?
Yep.
Which one do you like better, the little one or the big one?
Machine.
Where did you find a machine gun?
At the range.
You just found it? Just walking around up the O.
Yeah, I was...
Oh, look at this machine gun.
It was through the gun show loophole.
High tension, low action. That's not your shield.
Oh, he's got a shield.
That's all he knows how to fight with.
Ignoramus.
big round
things.
You can
still throw it like a boomerang. It'll be fine.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Just always finding hard round discs. That Lou Diamond Phillips, it is.
No.
It was.
Racist.
What? It was.
Come on. I don't think even he's a race.
He's like he's like The Rock.
Yeah. No race. Raceless human.
Or all of them.
No.
That's enough, clown.
Kind of looked like Martin Shkreli.
He's been a dick for a long time.
Yeah. It's enough, you clown. I'm going to buy that $1 million Wu-Tang album and never listen to it. That's the thing that I really hold. Did we talk about Shkreli on the last one of these?
Yeah, we did.
Okay, let's drop
we
it.
We did. You got a thing for the shit he's pulled?
I mean,
like you have a back room with his photo and like red lines connecting it to a bunch of other articles and stuff?
No, because nobody ever really does that in real life. It's only on TV.
Damn.
Literally no one's ever done that.
I'm going to throw away all my scripts.
Yeah. Let's see. We're an hour in.
Mm-hmm.
So we are, it looks like we're about 35 minutes out from the, what would you call it, the climax?
Yeah.
It's going to be like an epic battle with the Red Skull coming up probably pretty soon.
I don't know. I thought a fight ending and someone being launched on a nuclear weapon was...
Are you saying we should have watched this movie backwards?
I think they should have made this movie backwards.
Just like somehow like I don't know, like destroyed the film and like that somehow in this universe the movie already existed and then like
yeah
they sort of acted it in reverse and burnt the film in the process.
Yeah. Uh-huh. And for like an hour and 15 minutes you just kind of accept that Captain America is living in the 90s. And you don't really think twice about it because his comics are out of the 90s, but then they do that whole thing. You're like, oh, that's right. He was in the 40s. Mm-hmm. Quaint lab.
I think this is that cool, like, underground prison that Bruce Wayne broke out of in Batman 3. Do you remember Batman 3?
Bruce Willis wasn't in it.
Yeah. Was he?
Bruce Willis?
I feel like Bruce Willis would be a great Batman. Is it too late for that?
That's actually not a bad idea.
Yeah.
They can have him be like an older Batman.
They would have had to give him a wig. Because Batman has to have hair and Bruce Willis is bald.
Or he could just wear the mask the whole time, even while he's Bruce Wayne.
I think that's what the Lego Batman is going to be like.
Yeah.
Did you know they're coming out with like a whole Lego Batman movie?
Yep. And I'm all right because I like Will.
Yeah, it's good. It's going to be good.
Lou Diamond Phillips was not in this movie.
You checked?
He was too busy filming Young Guns 2. And Young Guns.
And La Bamba. And I'm a Celebrity, Get Me Out of Here.
Yeah. Yeah. You're getting them all right.
Yeah. And
he was in Dallas though.
Lou Diamond?
Mm-hmm.
Is Lou Diamond his first name?
Kerry,
do you know?
It's not.
Is Lou just Lou his first name?
Lou is his first name.
It's Lou.
And so, Diamond wait, is his
wait, he just did the throw up trick name. Again.
Oh my god. That's his signature move.
Here's what I do. This is my superhero move. I pretend to throw up, steal a car.
Steal a car.
Guy's a dick.
My Fiat. It's like more like fix it again, Tony. Right? Because they always break down. to the Italians. This is going to be good, right?
Yes.
The wind up. So the Italians, they're like car artisans.
Uh-huh.
They're just like every car they make has to be like this like delicately crafted thing.
Mm-hmm.
But they just, they aren't good at mass producing them. So that's why you get like a good, like, you know, you get a Lamborghini, like, you know, this work of art, pay like $1 million for it. But you get like a Fiat, it's in bad shape. No offense, Kerry, sorry.
It really doesn't matter because in the end, Captain America is going to puke and steal it. It's a good old Cappy puke and steal. It's like,
oh, I've got morning sickness.
Oh, you're pregnant.
I'm loving this white sneakers, white top, jeans.
Is it okay to wear shirts that baggy anymore?
No. He looks like Jerry Seinfeld.
Yeah, it's like the pirate puffy shirt.
Like, if you saw someone walking down the street wearing a shirt like that with jeans and tucked in, but like it could fit two of him inside.
Why doesn't this guy have sleeves?
Looks kind of like Chrissy and Maltasanti.
The fuck is this? I don't know. I just carried it, but
it's a speaking spell.
A good old Cappy speaking spell.
This is Silvio Marconi. Is he inventing the radio?
Oh, it's a click and listen. I think you're right, Byron.
This is the official scene where he finally invents the radio. We've been waiting for it. Is she the one that was in Pee-wee's Big Adventure?
Sure is.
Are you sure?
No. Yep.
She was like, hey, Pee-wee, I want to be your girlfriend. And then he's like, I'm a loner, Dottie.
Mm-hmm. It's her.
A rebel.
Really?
And then he bought all that, like, erotic child art. Remember?
Was it the Daily?
Huh?
Dottie.
Dottie, yeah. Dottie.
Elizabeth Daly.
I think she did the voice of Tommy Pickles.
Mm-hmm, she did.
No way she did.
I think, yeah. So is this her?
No. Yes.
Yeah.
It is?
I think so.
Did you Google it?
Why would
it?
You doubt this?
I mean, like, I was the one that said it, but mm-hmm. I feel like you're messing with me.
I am not.
Oh, no.
It's not her.
No, it's not her. Not the girl from Pee-wee's Big Adventure.
Why are there so many mean girls in this movie? It's like 90% mean girls.
This is the 90s.
Yeah. Are they drinking Perrier?
Mm-hmm.
God, Captain America's got deep pockets. They're just chilling with some Perrier there in Italy.
Perrier. I want a Perrier.
Just use a table as a shield.
Yeah. Hold on, I'll go steal another car. I'm going to steal this one.
Oh, I'm not feeling so good.
He just puked right on the spot.
Give me your Porsche.
It's not working. Run. No, these are my oranges.
Oh, man.
How many oranges have been lost to shitty car chases?
Really well, well choreographed, well shot scene. This kid's just like, I mean, come on.
They're really not doing anything to help themselves.
Why didn't they just move? Hey, is that, what's his name? He kissed Halle Berry at the Oscars.
Richard Grieco?
Yeah, Richard Grieco.
Adrian Brody.
Adrian Brody.
Adrian Brody.
Is it him, Kerry? Is it him?
It might be. More likely Richard Grieco, though.
Which one is Greco?
Why would you call him Greco? I just heard his name twice.
This Adrian Drecko?
This is how I say it, okay? That was the most heroic thing I've seen him do, and it was an accident. Oh, my spine! You guys got some sweet jean shorts.
Take this!
Here, have a few worthless lira.
Welcome to the EU. he probably didn't even do that on purpose either. Like, Captain America has just been one entire fuck up this whole movie.
He's a clown. He's a huge clown. So who is Richard Greco? Is he in Richard, Law and Order?
Richard Greco?
Law and Order.
No. That's Benjamin Bratt.
Oh, yeah.
He's in Lost. And
can't picture him.
Richard Greco?
Oh, wow. Richard Greco hasn't aged well at all.
Nope.
Poor guy. What was that movie he was famous for in the 90s?
License to Kill or something.
Oh, yeah. I remember Richard Greco.
If Looks Could Kill.
Yeah, he was good. He was good.
He was a fantastic actor.
Yeah, If Looks Could Kill. Oh, yeah, he looks like shit. He literally looks like the Crypt Keeper in this picture.
Like Edward James Olmos level.
Oh, no.
Why is he all puffed up?
If we ever get a chance to meet him, I want you to ask him that. Hey, Richard Greek. Why are you puffed up?
I wasn't talking about Richard Greek. I was talking about Captain America. I was.
Hey,
I don't know. What pictures are you looking at, Julian?
Why are you so puffy? so puffy up,
Yeah, Richard Greco, I feel like he could pass for John Stamos, right?
Nope.
Like now?
Yeah, or whenever.
Nope. Same level of sex appeal, right?
Yeah, not equal. Yeah. Equal hotness.
Yeah.
Do you think Richard Greco has ever been in a band?
Stop calling him that.
I feel like if he was in a band, it would be the band that Keanu Reeves had.
Oh, 30 Seconds to Mars.
No. No.
Yeah, I know what you're talking about.
The Bacon Brothers.
Yeah, Fabulous Bacon Brothers.
No, what?
It's Kevin Bacon and his brother's band.
Really?
Yeah. He's got a car phone.
That was Kevin Bacon right there, wasn't it?
Yeah. He was just about to meet up with Richard Greco to form Oingo Boingo.
Why are you doing it now?
You know who Richard Greco reminds me of is...
It sounds right.
The Mind Freak.
Chris Angel Greco?
Yeah. I feel like Chris Angel took a lot of notes from Richard Greco.
He had his poster on the wall for childhood. If I could be Richard Greco of magic. He got his first kiss because he used that line.
Richard Greco came onto 21 Jump Street and he was supposed to be like the new Johnny Depp.
Yeah.
Didn't quite take off.
No.
I feel like he looks just as good as JD.
Then and now?
For some reason there's
Why did
a picture.
He throw away his shield. Oh, she threw him away too.
Yeah.
She didn't even pretend to be sick first. There's a picture of Johnny Mathis mixed in with these pictures of Richard Greco that I'm looking at.
Oh, he is a stud. Is it the one where he's on the skis?
I mean, he looks horrible. he looks really old.
Johnny Mathis?
Yeah.
Oh, he looks like death himself.
Yeah. These were her favorite Bluetooth headphones from the future. I'm wearing some some Bluetooth headphones that look kind of like that. That's where that joke came from.
Yeah. Do you feel like Captain America now?
I feel like we're about to get a little bit red shoe here, guys. All right. Some,
David Duchovny off in the background reading a letter.
Yep. Lady Prison. Sensual. What? It's a good, really business, professional, casual look.
I like it.
Is that Breakfast at Tiffany's? That just
Audrey Hepburn.
Yeah, Hepburn. That's the one.
Yeah, she made a cameo. You don't say. He has a taser, too. Yeah. Gonna tase his face off. Oh! I seem to have got a nice... Oh!
I just sent you guys a picture of Richard Greco.
That's a man right there?
Yeah. He's kind of like emerging from the water.
It's a concrete. I remember this picture.
Do you have it on your wall or in your locker or in your dream book? Wish book?
Do you currently have it in your locker?
Did you have it like printed out 10 times and stacked in your hope chest?
Yes.
Where was it, Kerry? Where'd you keep the picture? Where'd you keep the picture?
I had like a trapper keeper.
Ah, trapper.
And, well, I didn't have a locker because I didn't have anything really. It was a sad school.
Oh, you see,
what is that? Catholic. Is that him today?
That's Richard Johnny Mathis.
Johnny Mathis.
Oh, no!
Yeah.
That's what Johnny Mathis looks like now? Oh, that's tragic.
He looks awful.
He looks like the Red Skull with the strange paint on his face.
What do you think Corey Haim looks like these days?
He's dead, Byron.
Yeah, but what do you think he looks like these days?
Probably pretty rough.
Probably better than Johnny Mathis.
He probably has a beautiful mausoleum.
Yeah.
Yeah, I already saw that picture. That's old news.
Ah, damn.
It was really good for the people listening that can't see the pictures.
Yeah, we're having a whole conversation about photos that we're sharing just between us three.
If you're listening, which I would be shocked if anybody did, but just Google Richard Greco 2015, and you'll see all these pictures.
And Johnny Mathis.
I'm actually really surprised that Ronnie Cox is not a bad guy in this. Like, I really thought he was going to be, like, the president.
He usually is, isn't he?
Yeah. Like 99% of the time.
And what? I've never seen him as a bad guy.
Cohagen? From Total Recall?
Total Recall, yeah.
Get with it. Get with the program.
Yeah. Come on, Byron.
What else does there need to be? I'm just going to quickly maybe Google it.
Get him. Enemies, an old man. We're young men with guns. He's making an escape. Oh shit, he's got a cannon now. Oh no, he's not.
Whoa. Ronnie Cox's IMDb is really flattering. It says Ronnie Cox is a superbly talented actor, singer.
You're missing Captain America. Do something heroic.
Yep. Oh.
Do you not care about Ronnie Cox's IMDb description? Because let me start over again. Ronnie Cox is a superbly talented actor, singer, songwriter, and musician who has been consistently active in Hollywood for over 40 years, portraying a diverse range of characters.
Diverse. See, not always villains.
He was born in Cloudcroft, New Mexico, and received positive reviews in his first film role for portrayal of ill-fated businessman Drew Ballinger.
That was a near miss there.
It's Captain Hero.
He saved a life. Good for him.
He was a villain in RoboCop.
Yep.
He was not a villain in Deliverance. He was just a victim, I think.
He was just a man.
So is that enough, Kerry? Is that...
You still gave me just RoboCop.
RoboCop and Total Recall.
Oh, Total... Oh, sorry. I thought that was the same thing.
Yeah, well... Yeah. Well, yeah. Was he a villain in RoboCop? I forget. Yeah, he was like the... Geico CEO.
The Geico CEO?
Yeah, I couldn't remember the name of the evil corporation.
Omni Consumer Corp, whatever.
Yeah, Globex.
I made a fake Facebook account.
Oh, really?
And yeah, and he works for Omni Consumer Corp. And his relationship status is it's complicated.
I have a fake Facebook account.
Oh yeah?
Called what's it called?
They should become friends.
It's John Cena Awareness Month.
I've seen it.
The last time it was updated, it changed to Year of Cena, I think. Like, the whole year is going to be devoted to John Cena. And he's doing a tour of the Holy Land.
The John Cena Jubilee Celebration.
He's doing a tour of the Holy Land with Mike the Situation Sorrentino.
And you know, B-Bars has another one, too.
Really?
Yeah. Other B-Bars.
Is this like a... Oh, I think I've seen other B-Bars.
Yeah. Yeah, and my fake one, his name is Pablo Judesca.
You guys really get into some freaky antics.
Yep.
I guess I'll try to friend.
We fight crime with our false identities.
How many followers or friends do you have with these accounts?
With Pablo Judesca?
Yeah.
He's got like... 69, 70 friends.
That's pretty good. That's probably more real friends than I have as my real self.
Well, it's because like I have four or five friends who have his login too, so they just friend everyone.
Oh.
So the friends that he has are either people that who are in on it or people who don't practice safe internet practices.
Right. Like old ladies.
What does that mean?
Just having a stranger. Like accepting a stranger's friend request?
What he's saying is that this is all happening on the dark net, the dark web.
on the Facebook dark net. on the deep, deep dangerous web.
This is the Silk Road.
The Silk Road of friends. Mm-hmm.
Ridiculous.
When is this dude becoming Red Skull again?
His eye hole looks like it was cut out with safety scissors. Look at it when it pops up again. It's never gonna happen again. Thanks a lot, asshole, Captain America. Show it again. Come, there it is. President Cox, at your service. Think back
Courtney,
here.
No.
Is that Lloyd Braun? Oh, this is a perfectly sane food to eat.
He cut his gun in half.
One of my toenails just came off.
Oh my god.
Cut that out.
Because of what Captain America is doing.
Whoa! Karate.
Super serum.
This isn't parkour.
It's like regular people who could do that.
Yeah, I think I could do that.
Yeah.
I can't.
You know, Kerry, like, please administer the test and make sure he can do it.
He can't. I know.
Wait, they're brothers?
Yeah.
This is like a sort of like when Luke Skywalker found out Chewbacca was gay.
Wah, wah.
Bait and switch there.
Yeah.
Ooh.
Yeah, you're not Captain America. You can't pick up the shield.
Just throw it like a frisbee.
You don't have super soldier serum.
So they're just taking turns punching, like they're not.
Yep.
You get one. I get one. It's like they're sharing a malt.
He owes them like three. You could have run after him, but no.
What? Steve, it'll be much cooler if you do this than if you just kind of, like, stomp on his head. Oh.
That boosted his ego.
I thought the president was dead for a second there. Shield makes a lot of noise.
No. They're not very aerodynamic for sound. That's not even...
Is that one of those sound effects that you were telling me about?
Kerry. It's Foley. Foley work. Foley. So, like,
I'm
here's
hearing like all of these noises coming out of the screen, and I don't know what they are or where they're coming from.
What I was going to explain was, like, so, okay, remember Jurassic Park?
Mm-hmm.
Remember the scene where the raptor was coming out of the egg?
Mm-hmm.
And it was like, this is like a sound like this. Just listen. That was actually Foley work. And this is what how it was done, okay?
Okay, you go.
Rubber dish glove rubbing dish liquid, like soap.
Uh-huh.
And you try it, it'll sound like...
It is what you just did Foley work?
No. I mean, yes. It's actually voice acting, I think.
Are those fake ears on his costume?
Like Vulcan ears?
They look like plastic ears. They're not even the same skin tone. On Captain America. Like, it's like his suit has fake ears.
Like hell I can't. Is he Liberace now?
Maybe. I'm Red Skull.
Is that like Dr. Claw?
I'll get you, Gadget.
Do not mess
You're a fool, Captain America. Jesus.
Ugh. Wait, he still hasn't caught on fire yet, and I'm beginning to think that wasn't the Chekhov's gun situation where they were talking about his fireproof suit.
Yeah, maybe.
I think they probably forgot.
What a waste of a Chekhov's gun.
Yeah. It's got quite a bulge there. Mighty package.
To deliver American babies.
He's got a real ballpark Frank.
A real kielbasa.
He's got a real kielbasa covered in sauerkraut and cheese whiz.
And a couple of peaches.
This is such a quintessentially American meal. You take some two Georgia peaches.
Here at Roxy's Diner, we serve peaches and kielbasa.
A couple of... Too long Chicago kielbasa.
Four peaches. Freshly shorn peaches.
You tie those kielbasa together. Mm-hmm. Cover them with cherries. Maraschino cherries.
I'm hungry enough that I would try that. What?
How did he not see this coming? That's all he does is throw the shield. And he had it. It's
like, he was like seconds ago, he saw him picking it up and...
He just didn't see that as a possibility.
He's a smart ass too.
Hold on to your butt. What happened to her? Did she just vanish? Was she teleported to the Forbidden
Zone? Yeah, she's just obliterated.
Now we got the Spetsnaz coming in. We're going to fight the Chechen rebels. Secret identity ruined.
Son of a bitch. I wonder what this actor is doing now.
There's no way to find out.
Like,
there's no possible way we could ever know.
Like, is this Captain America his magnum opus?
You know, I'm actually literally on IMDb, right? And like, the screen is open to it.
He was in What Dreams May Come and Revenge of the Nerds.
Yeah, didn't he play like the big guy, like the angry guy?
I don't know. He was in Law and Order Special Victims Unit.
Right. So this was a Mannheim Golan production. So just like Urban Warriors also was a Golan. Golan,
really?
Globus.
How is it that you guys remember all that?
It's just a lot smarter than you.
I mean, I get.
It's like when you're smart, like you got like the chops mentally, you just like retain. Yeah.
Like,
lots
things
of
just,
information.
You just remember things and you can just say what you remember.
But it's not just memory, it's also like you know, like Mozart?
Uh-huh.
Like what he does with piano keys, I do with like thoughts and memories.
Oh.
Like I play them into like a symphony.
I wish I could be that smart.
And intellect.
It's fun, right?
No, it's actually a huge burden.
It's a burden. It's a curse.
Stop it.
Because, you know, there's so many expectations on you.
Yeah.
You know?
It's heavy is the head.
People are like, this guy is going to make a difference.
Uh-huh.
You know?
And how many differences have you made?
Zero.
Oh,
I mean, probably
man.
Some bad negative ones.
Oh, man, that's unfortunate. So if you've made zero... How many differences did Captain America make in this movie?
I feel like he didn't make much of a difference either.
He ruined a couple of lives by stealing cars.
It's true. He got that Ned Beatty killed. Did he die?
Ned Beatty?
Or is he still convalescing?
I don't know. I kind of feel like he's still rolling around in her house with a open wound in his back.
I feel like he is still like out on the road somewhere looking for his car. why did he betray me? He was his biggest fan.
Cursing Captain America's name under his breath.
It's the last time he's ever going to pull over and let anyone throw up.
Yep.
It's going to be a real trigger for him going forward.
Yep.
Why, what's with this country song?
It's America. You don't feel America doing listening to this?
I've never really understood like why country music gets to be quintessentially American. Like, why not rap music that's just as American?
Yeah.
Why not jazz that's just as American? Why can't that be like the default?
Because they're not making songs about the USA.
I feel like a lot of jazz songs are kind of about like the soul of America, though, you know?
Yeah.
These are some of the really deep smart thoughts I was talking about earlier, Julian.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. That's what I was going to ask. When does your new jazz album drop?
It's going to be like an acapella slash scat beatbox.
Acapella, that's my favorite.
That's my favorite.
Do you, do you also do the Foley work on the instruments too?
Yeah.
Like
listen to it.
Byron, you move me.
Imagine the raptor's claws coming out of the slime within the egg.
Like for the whole album, it's kind of like that Gregorian chant CD that came out in the 90s.
Yeah, it was called Monks. All right, we did it. That was the end. Hooray!
We did it.
Woo, that was rough. That was tough. Tough and rough.
Okay, so what you were saying at the beginning of the movie is that B-Barth definitely loses a point, maybe two.
I don't know. Do you think so? I mean, I was going to actually maybe put it to a vote, but there's only two people that are allowed to vote here.
Uh-huh.
So let's aren't allowed to
it's
vote
not
yet.
That women aren't. It's just that you're not like a full member of the club yet. So
the boys club.
No. silly. No. I think, I don't know. I mean, he only has one point. Technically, this is the third session, possible session, that he's missed. But so should that be minus 3 points?
Yes.
Minus 3 plus 1. So minus 2 total.
How many points do you have?
I think I've got like 10.
What? You should have no points.
I think I gave myself 10 points as like a joke.
Like off air?
No, I think it was on air, and it was like a joke, but I think that I have the power to do it so they actually are real and stick.
They retain.
Yeah. I have 1 point. I think everybody has 1 point each, and now Jan has 1 point. And whether or not Bibars loses a point maybe depends on... Should we make him like write an essay or something on what he did wrong?
That's what I was going to suggest, that we take the points away, but he can redeem himself with extra credit.
Yeah.
Extra credit.
I think either an essay.
What I would like is if he would do a couple of these just by himself, and just submit them.
And he has to go through the whole point process too. Like he has to pick movies that he hasn't seen.
Yeah, and just make jokes to himself.
Either that, or he posts a photo of himself holding a sign saying, "I missed last week's episode because my wife gave birth to my child."
Yeah,
like a punishment.
Why do you want to see that though? What does that do for you? Why would you want him to do that?
It puts order back into the world, guys.
Just like messing with people. You're a bully. Do you like bullying people?
It's like he needs an authority figure in his life.
That's true.
And I'm happy to step up.
He actually told me that he does see you as kind of like a father figure, but not like a real father, but like the George Michael song. Yeah.
Oh, okay. I can roll with that.
Yeah. All right. So, any takeaways from this Captain thing movie? We watched. Kerry.
Captain America is a dick.
Excuse me, Julian. I was asking Kerry.
I always do that.
Kerry, do you?
I found him incredibly unimpressive.
Yeah, he didn't have any real powers or do anything. I mean, he did block some bullets with a shield.
I'm not sure what that serum even did to him.
It didn't
at
do
all.
Anything.
His body
it
didn't
his
change
limp.
Except his limp. But even with his limp fixed, he wasn't able to run very fast.
Yeah. It was sort of like that. Remember that contraption that Mr. Bates wore on his leg in the first season of Downton Abbey? It was pretty much a glorified version of that. Julian, did you see the first season of Downton Abbey?
No.
Okay.
Spoiler alert. Master makes himself a strange leg cast.
It's not even spoiled because he doesn't even know that he ultimately ends up throwing it in the lake.
Fuck.
So, Julian, what is your takeaway?
I'm throwing my Downton Abbey DVDs into the trash right now.
Just scraping them off your plate into the garden.
Yeah.
So, Julian, what is your takeaway? So, the Captain America's dick?
I was going to say that, but I feel more like Cox doesn't always have to be a bad guy.
Yeah, that's true.
He's a pretty effective good guy, too. Yeah. I mean, Captain America said thanks and thumbed up.
Did I read Ronnie Cox's bio to you guys yet?
Yes.
You did, but I don't think you finished.
Okay.
Yes, you did.
It's really long. It's three very long paragraphs.
He's making music and acting for 40 years.
The second paragraph begins, interestingly, comma, Cox was often at his best playing rigorous authority figures, etc. Et
Thank you. Thank you very much.
Oh, he's also on a list of top movie, quote, dickheads.
Oh.
Yeah. Which is...
I'm glad they wrote that exactly.
Yeah. So my takeaway from Captain America was that it was not that good. I didn't really like that much. I don't know why they made Red Skull a talent. He's German. He's a Nazi.
Or he's supposed to be.
He's not like a. What were the Italian Nazis called? Fascists. Chauvinistas.
I guess. Sure. Yeah.
All right.
What was it again one more time?
Chauvinistas.
That sounds accurate. That sounds history bookish.
Yeah.
All right. So
we did it.
We did it, yeah. So what's our hashtag? Do same shit, different asshole? Is that too generic?
Yeah, that's too generic.
What about Chauvinistas?
Chauvinistas. It's pretty good.
I think we should just play with this one since nobody uses it anyway.
Yeah.
Yeah. Either do Chauvinistas or Captain Puke and Steely.
Captain Puke and Steely. Puke and Steel. Puke and Steel. Hashtag Captain Puke and Steel. Should it be Captain Puke and Steel or is that too long?
I don't know.
Is it puke and steel? Like
it's gonna be puke and steel.
Is it puke and steel or puke
no,
and
no,
steel?
It's puke and apostrophe steel. But you can't do that in a hashtag.
You can't put an apostrophe in a hashtag. You're gonna stay on the internet.
He's gonna lose like hundreds.
Don't you internet, Julian?
Of really confusing hashtags.
Get out of this podcast, okay. Julian.
Hashtag puke and steel. Hashtag puke and steel. Puke and steel. Yeah. Puke and steel. Yeah.
Puke and Steel.
Puke and Steel
3D. What?
It wasn't 3D.
All right. We're at the 2-hour mark, so let's call it,
we're
guys.
Good. We're good.
All right. Julian, thanks again. This has been a real blast. And Kerry, thank you for filling in for B-Bars.
Yeah, Kerry, thank you so much.
It's been a delight and a pleasure.
You're very welcome.
And I think that you had a good time, so that's the important thing. All right. Next time.
Yep.
All right. Thanks for tuning in, everybody.
Have a good night, everybody.
Take care.
Bye-bye.
Bye.